over the stunning water of the Fiji Islands. A place once known for its cannibalism, uncharted reefs, and formidable warriors. These islands are home to spectacular sea life and lush, jagged terrain. Just below are 19 strangers that represent an extreme cross-section of America. From a former homeless street performer to a Harvard-educated lawyer, they have been given absolutely no information. The fear of the unknown is so strong that one survivor quit just moments before being set adrift miles from shore. Exile Island is back with hundreds of deadly sea snakes. And this time, two hidden immunity idols will complicate the game like never before. 39 days, 19 people, one survivor.
When I got there, I noticed that we were like all 19 of us together. I thought that Jeff was gonna be there and we were gonna be like split into tribes and you go this way and you go the other way. But it wasn't the case.
Hey buddy, I haven't met you yet. What's your name?
Yao Man.
Yao Man?
Yao
Man. I'm Boo. B-O-O.
In my past, where I used to work and stuff, they call me Stallone. They call me, I guess I look like Sylvester Stallone or Rocky. I have droopy eyes, dark hair. For some reason, James is too hot for them to remember. So Rocky is, will suffice.
We were so excited just to get here. Didn't matter what we were doing. We were lost on a deserted island. You know, what would anybody do? Go explore.
Oh, it's one!
Yeah, one!
Hey, good job.
Water!
Where?
Got a couple mosquitoes in.
Tell you right now, I lost my mind. I didn't know what to do. I didn't know what to say. I was running around like a chicken with my head cut off.
We look and there's this big, beautiful cave. We're like, this is a blessing. We're like, we're great.
I found a lemon tree.
We've got banana trees over there. We've got papaya over there. We are stoked.
I want to see what's up there.
Well, my real name is Andre. But on this beach, I just go by Dreams.
I'm a natural Fiji. Fiji. Yeah, you know what I mean?
I came up with the name Dreams a long time ago. It was more of a name of strive and achievement.
I'm glad we came up here.
Now look at this.
It's like buying a new house. You know, you want to see everything. The backyard, the front yard, the living room, the dining room. You want to see everything that's in your house. And this is our house.
I'm the king of Fiji.
Of an unnamed island.
I don't know, I'm standing the highest.
Open. My outdoor experience up to this point consisted of being maybe 20 to 40 feet off the road. This is totally new for me, sleeping outdoors, finding food. Love coconut, but it's granulated already, shredded in the grocery store, so.
Eating coconut without any implement is a test of patience.
It is, I see.
But believe me, it's worth it.
Oh, okay. Have you ever got to the coconut without
instruments?
Yes. Oh,
I grew up on the island of Borneo.
Oh, where's that near?
That's like the same vegetation as this.
Wow, so you're native, huh?
I'm native, almost. I am definitely trying to prove myself. I can see that all the other guys are quite young, like half my age. Old people are usually the first one to get booted off, so I'm hoping that I will be an exception here because I know the surrounding. I can help get them coconut to drink.
Did he just open that? Oh, thanks.
So what are you thinking right now?
Man, I don't know. Too many people in one place right now. It's kind of what makes me a little bit nervous.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I mean, there's 19 of us. I mean, so how do you split that up into two tribes?
We're like, you know, looking around the island for a machete. We're looking for like flags for a tribe. We don't have a pot. We don't have water. We don't have anything. We don't even know our tribe name, you know? It's incredibly overwhelming because there's so many people. And none of us have a clue what's going on. We're looking for Jeff Probst. We're like, where's Jeff?